It was time to move forward to the northeast of New Vegas in order to find what happened to the Brotherhood Patrol. When I reached the premises of New Vegas, the night had been already deep. I decided to rest in the Followers of Apocalypse clinic not far away from the city. There I asked about suspicious and strange people. Dr. Yuzanage remembered that one of her patients mentioned a group in hulking metal suits that ventured toward the Boomer's territory. She told me that those Boomers are a xenophobic group that hold themselves on the territory of the Pruor Air Base. They have an overwhelming firepower and use it on anybody who tries to get close to their land. Without more useful information, I had no choice but to look at those Boomers by myself, though I was sure now that the patrol is dead. I had a nice rest. It is time to go. I think that the doctor said to follow this road. Then I should turn to the north at the T-junction. Strange, but there are no raiders here. It looks like those Boomers really savages of this part of the wasteland, since even Finns don't dare to get close to their territory. Right after the railroad, behind hills should be the Boomers' territory. Let's see how dangerous they are.
Whoa there, pal. You better slow down, or you'll get blown up like the rest of the idiots who thought they'd scavenge in Boomer territory. Now that I've got your attention, might you be interested in a little information? It'll cost you, but it's well worth the investment. Oh, lordy, lordy. You haven't heard of the Boomers? What rock have you been living under? They're a bunch of artillery-slinging, grenade-lobbing odd-jobs camping out in Nellis. Wander into their territory and you're as good as mincemeat. There is a way, and I'll tell you. For a little wager. Well, I know the secret to get past. If you give me the caps, I'll tell you. If you make it back alive, I'll double your money. Okay, here you go. That page has the details, but it's all in the timing as you move from building to building. I'll be here watching, so I'll know if you've made it to the gate or not. Remember, there's 600 caps in it if you make it.
300 caps. I hope this note is worth it. The key to avoiding the artillery is to move from building to building up the northwest side of town toward the front gate. Stick to the high cover in the northeast corner of the two buildings, then make a beeline for the gate. The Boomers won't shoot at their own people, so stick to the fence until you make it to the gate. Also, I know there is an old train tunnel that enters the area from the south, but no one has ever come back out of there to say it is safe. The only useful part here is that the Boomers avoid friendly fire. Well, go. Sorry, but you have to wait me here. I doubt that running from building to building is going to help me. I think I can just run as fast as possible and get to the gate to their territory. There, I can deal with the boomers one way or another. Well, it is time for some exercise. I'm almost there.
Hold it right there. Don't you move. How the hell did you survive that bombardment? Are you even human? Some kind of mutant? Move a muscle now and I'll blow you to pieces. Watch your mouth, Savage. Raquel will be here any second.
I'll take this from here. I'm Raquel, Master-at-Arms for the Nellis Homeland. Mother Pearl, our eldest, wishes to speak to you. Follow close and mind your behavior.
Welcome, child. Took your sweet time getting here, didn't you? I've been waiting a good 5 years for an outsider to come along and visit. Those howitzers of ours aren't just for entertainment, child. Explosive ordnance is what keeps the savages at a distance. Except you. There's something special about you, child, and it was the howitzers that gave you a chance to show it. Oh, so many ways. Small ones to begin with, so we can get used to what it's like to have a outsider around and about. Should that go well, it may be you can help in big ways, too. We'll have to see. You have to keep in mind that you're our first contact with the outside world since I was barely a woman. Seclusion has kept us safe, but the world around us is changing. Neon lights in the distance, patrolling robots, soldiers. My youngers think our guns can keep out the world, but I think we need to let it in just a little, or become its victim. You're that little bit of the world, child. Welcome to Nellis. You picked a good time to stop by, for we're swimming in problems. My youngers can tell you all about it. Raquel could use help with the bug problem. Doc Argyle has wounded he's tending to. And Loyal and Jack might be looking for help with some repairs. Or you could just go see Pete at the museum and hear the story of our people. All you have to do there is listen. Come and go as you like, help or don't help, I leave it up to you. But I hope you'll show my youngers that not every outsider needs to be blown up.
Such hospitality. Security here is pretty lax. However, considering how good their perimeter is protected. These barracks look well maintained, to some degree. Well, let's do what I usually do to befriend locals. Pest extermination services. So far it worked well in Good Springs, Prim, the outpost, and the Camp Macaron. I am glad that I can speak of children casually. It took some time to get information about the Master-at-Arms. Adults here are mostly idiots who don't know how weak their defense is. Because of this, their arrogance has no limits. Let's go up and talk with the chief of the security here. Hospitality is not their strong trait. Well, whatever.
Mother Pearl's instructions are clear. You can move freely around Nellis, and artillery spotters have orders not to fire on you. These are extraordinary privileges. Don't abuse them. Long story short, the power failed a few days ago because giant ants have tunneled into the generator room and set up a nest. I led a team down to exterminate them, but there were so many of them. We lost. 2 killed, 3 wounded. Personally, I think it's more than a savage can handle. But if you want to kill those ants and switch the power back on, feel free. Don't get my hopes up. One other thing. The ants must be eating gunpowder from the munitions down there, or something. They exploded when hit by a flamethrower. One of us was using a laser pistol. Same thing. Bullets seem okay, just don't hit the artillery shells. Loyal's been working on some kind of weapon to use against them. Maybe you should check with him.
Her pride and arrogance clearly displays her lack of training and skills. She can't even deal with Severalants. I hope the chief engineer here is better than this clone. Children told me that the workshop is located in one of their hangars. Let's check the closest one first. That old man should be loyal. A strategic bomber, or at least what left of it.
I hope Pearl knows what she's doing, letting you wander around Nellis as you please. I started building a sonic emitter that might do the trick, but it's useless without knowing the exact frequency that would kill the ants. Hot damn, you're right! It's a matter of boosting across those thresholds, not exact amplitude. You're smarter than you look. Just so happens, I was testing it at 24,000 hertz, so it should be good to go. Place it near their nest and cross your fingers. Signal's too high for people to hear, so no harm done. But it might make you feel sick to your stomach.
At least this one has some ideas, and he is more friendly than others here. Let's test his device. In the worst case, I will do it the same way as with Jackson's ants. Wrong turn. Still, that place is kept clean. I think that place is the emergency power plant of this air base. It is time for summoned extermination business. I wonder if my plasma blaster will make us here explode. No explosion. It is kind of disappointing. That Master Atoms could tell quite tall tales. Ants are not a problem. Incompetencies. That thing looks like a place from which Ents got here. Let's put the device. I believe it turns on light. If it worked, those Ents should be dead by now. I need to restore power generation. I have to turn off residual current device or its analog here before powering the power plant. That should be the main switch. I found them. So, the first device is off. Second as well. Time to turn on the power. The job is done. Let's check the power grid parameters and leave. Everything looks nice. With all Ents eliminated and power restored, it was time to meet the Master Atoms once again. To show how incompetent her ways are.
I see the power's back on. The ants are all dead? Maybe Pearl is right about you. Because I don't know how you pulled that off. I'll tell Loyal to send someone down to clear out the eggs and repair the generators. Good work.